We are holding in our hands 450 grams of disappointment. Hi, my name is Tanmay.
And my name is Sushmita.
Welcome to Fully Booked, where we talk about books written by South Asian authors. And today we are going to discuss Cobalt Blue by Sachin Kundalkar.
This book is about two siblings, Tanay and Anuja, who fall in love with their tenant. We don't know a whole lot about this tenant. We don't even know his name, but we do know that he's an orphan, a painter, and he had sexual relations with both the siblings at the same time. And they had no idea that this was going on.
Like a love triangle?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, production team, can you get me my popcorn right now?
It's not like that, dude.
I'm already losing interest. Like, why should anyone read this book in 2018?
Firstly, India legalized gay sex this year by striking down Section 377. And this book talks about the initial vestiges of how gay people were organizing politically to fight for their rights.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
That's really interesting. And the reader can be assured that the experiences in the book are authentic, as the writer of this book is openly gay. This book has two parts. In the first part, Tanay relives his relationship with the mystery guy who has left him. He longs for him in the form of a letter, or so it seems. In the second part, we are reading Anuja's diary entry, where she pines for this mystery guy. What's beautiful to see is the characters grow emotionally through their heartbreak.
Yeah, Tanay moves away to Bombay to pursue art and activism more seriously, and Anuja starts out confused in the beginning, but really grows into her own woman in the end. And I really liked that.
Me too, absolutely.
Do you know what this cover is?
I don't know.
So I knew it. I knew you wouldn't know.
Wait, it's so confusing. Does it mean anything to you guys? Like, there's like three rods and a red towel, which reminds me of my mom's tolia in the kitchen.
It's an easel.
In English, can you explain what this is?
An easel is a stand for canvases that painters use.
Oh, all right, Miss Oxford. I absolutely didn't know that. And since you know so much, maybe you can tell us, why is this book called Cobalt Blue?
Well, if you stop with that attitude, I might actually get to it by the end.
Whatever.
Anyway, we shouldn't make light of this book. This book was a bold novel to be written at that time. Firstly, it was written in Marathi, an Indian regional language. And secondly, it was written in 2006, when gay sex was considered a criminal offense punishable for life.
I know, and the toughest part would be being strangers to your own family and friends, you know, probably so many of them still are. I can't imagine how it must feel to have your entire existence invalidated like that.
And just to put that into context, the percentage of LGBTQ identifying people around the world in countries that legalized gay sex is around 4%. So if you applied the same fraction of people to India, we would have about 4 crore people identifying as LGBTQ amongst us in India today. And that, by the way, is the entire population of Canada.
Wow, that's insane. 40 million people?
Yeah.
Wow. And this is one of the minuscule number of books that gives voice to such a huge invisible population. There are probably more books written on Indian cricket captains than there are LGBTQ novels. So for writing a trailblazer novel for its time, we really, really commend Sachin Kundalkar.
And here is where the title is meaningful.
Finally.
So, Cobalt Blue is obviously the color of choice of the painter, mystery guy in the novel, but the color blue itself has been surfacing around queer popular media globally. Take for instance the recent Oscar-winning movie Moonlight, which is about a gay black man, was shot entirely in blue hues, or that 2013 French lesbian romance drama called Blue is the Warmest Color, and I'm sure there are many such examples. I mean, I just think that the global queer community is reclaiming the color blue, and that is an original idea. And if you thought that was interesting, Tanay's part of the novel is written entirely in second person, where he uses the word you to ruminate about his male lover, the mystery guy. I think this is done deliberately. So think about this. Almost everything we see in the media today is assuming a straight male's perspective to frame what or who and how someone can be portrayed as desirable. Mm-hmm. And Sachin Kundalkar in this book takes that and flips it with a queer male's perspective to show what desire looks like.
Yeah, it absolutely unsettled me when I was going through the paragraphs, when Tanay was writing a second person, when he was looking at his mystery lover.
Mm-hmm.
It's bound to make some straight men absolutely unsettled when they read this.
Are you ready for that, straight men?
Everything is fine and dandy up till now, but you know, Sushmita, I have a huge issue with this book.
Okay.
I can't decide whether it was the original text or the translation made me feel that way, but it certainly reads weird at places.
Hmm.
Like, sample this sentence on page number 27, for example. So it reads, "He gave her her pills." Which in Marathi would be Tyani Tila Tyachi Goya Dilya, or in Hindi it would be Usne Usko Uski Dawai Di. Does it not sound awkward to you?
Okay.
And moreover, not only just this, this book is written with the coherence of a 5-year-old.
That's a little harsh.
I know, and I'm really sorry to say that, but it's peppered with abrupt transitions that are jarring.
Okay, such as what?
Take for example the introduction of auxiliary characters.
Hmm.
They are introduced out of thin air and are culled at will, almost with the Games of Thrones-esque efficiency, all within a space of 500 words. And I kept on clinging to a string of continuity in the novel that just did not exist.
Fascinating that you say that. I mean, it started off like that for me, but the moment I thought that this was a stylistic choice,
mm-hmm.
By the author that the translator kept,
mm-hmm.
it made it better reading. For example, the first part is written like a letter and the second like a diary, and I thought it stuck true to its form without giving any backstory whatsoever. I mean, just imagine writing backstory in your own diary. It felt like I was piecing together this intricate puzzle of these people's secret lives.
Well, congratulations. I don't want to sound mean, but I don't like to solve word puzzles in my free time. And what I'd like to do instead is to look for mean reviews when I'm free.
While giving it 1 star on Amazon, Carol writes, "What a waste of time and money."
It totally was.
Oh, come
this,
on.
We are holding in our hands 450 grams of disappointment.
You.
Okay, I hope that's me. Jasoon on Goodreads has some sarcasm up his sleeve. He writes, "A bisexual person uses his powers of invisibility for evil."
Okay, that's a liberal interpretation of evil if you ask me.
I know, how can anyone get this impression after reading this novel?
I don't know why I bother, but final thoughts, Tanmay?
You know, to describe my feelings about this book, I would like to use an analogy. Imagine you are piecing together a complicated jigsaw puzzle. You know, after spending hours of work at it, you found out that the puzzle shows no more than the individual pieces themselves. This is how I felt after reading this book. There is no story in the book that comes together by piecing together the individual paragraphs. And that's the real tragedy. For its time, this book had trailblazing concepts and ideas. And I really wish Sachin Kundalkar did a good job writing a more gripping, a more compelling story.
You mean Jerry Pinto?
Yeah, or maybe Jerry Pinto.
Mm.
But because this, it feels like a half-hearted story, and for that, I'm not going to read it again.
You know, to be really honest with you, Tanmay, I'm struggling with weighing the writing quality of this novel with its significance
mm-hmm.
for the times. If only this book was recreated and retold anew for an English-speaking audience, this book would have been a marvelous novel, instead of being a shadow of an original that I may never be able to read. Well, I guess I'll just have to learn Marathi to find out, huh?
So you will read it, but in Marathi.
Mi aasha karto.
If you liked our video, please like, share and subscribe to our channel. And do let us know what you feel about this book if you have read it in the comment section down below.
So saying goodbye once again, this is Tanmay.
And that's Sushmita. Bye-bye. Bye.